How's it going, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys a few useful methods of the math class. And at the end of this video, we're going to create a program where we will find the hypotenuse of a triangle. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Alrighty then, guys and gals, in this video I'm going to demonstrate a few useful methods of the math class. To begin, we'll need maybe two numbers. Let's say that these will be double variables. Double x, let's set this equal to 3.14, and double y, we will set this to, let's say, negative 10. Alright, the first useful method is the max method. This will find the larger of two numbers. So in order to use the max method, we're going to type math with a capital M dot, and there's a few recommendations here. What we would like is the max method. That is right here. So there's a few to choose from. We can compare two integers, two long values, two floats, and two doubles. I'm going to compare the values of x and y. So I'm going to put these within the parentheses of my max method. And then we can either display the result or assign this to a new variable. Let's say double z equals math.max, and we'll compare x and y and assign the larger number to variable z. And we will display the result. System.out.println z. And the larger of these two numbers is, in fact, x, which is 3.14. And there is also a min method, which will find the lesser of two values, which is variable y, which is negative 10. Another useful method is the absolute function method. It's just abs, like abs, six-pack abs. And we'll pass in y. And this will display the absolute value of y, which is 10. So the absolute value is basically a number without the negative sign. I'm not a mathematician, so I could be wrong in that definition. Alright, we also have the square root function, that is sqrt. The square root of y, I don't know what the square root of negative 10 is, but we're about to find out. I don't know, I guess that didn't work. Let's change y to 10. 3.16 blah 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 blah. Alright, that is the square root function. We can also round. Let's round x. So x rounded is 3.0. On the other hand, ceil, like ceiling, this will always round up. So 3.4 or 3.14 always rounded up is 4. And floor will always round down. So 3.14 always rounded down is 3.0. Here's a project that we can work on. Let's create a program that will find the hypotenuse of a triangle, and we will ask the user for side x and side y. So to begin, let's declare two variables, double x and double y. Actually, I take that back. Let's declare double z as well, because z will be the result, the hypotenuse. We'll also need a scanner to accept some user input. Scanner, scanner equals new scanner. Within the parentheses, we're going to type system.in. We'll need an import, so include this import at the top. Import java.util.Scanner. We'll need a prompt for side x and side y. We can do that with a print line statement. Enter side x. I can't type today. And we will store the result within variable x. X equals, we need some user input, scanner.nextDouble, because we would like a double value. Let's repeat the process for side y. Enter side y. We'll store the result within variable y. Now here's the tricky part. There is a mathematical formula to calculate the hypotenuse given two angles, well, two sides of a triangle. So this is what we're going to do. First, we'll multiply x times x plus y times y. Then we need to put this within the square root function of the math class. Math, make sure it's with a capital M, dot sqrt. And we are going to take all of this and place this within the square root function. And we will assign this to our variable of z. So z equals math.squareroot x times x plus y times y. And with a print line statement, we can display the hypotenuse is plus z. That should be good. Oh, then it's good practice to close your scanner. I always forget to do that, although it's not necessary. Scanner.close. All right, let's test this. Enter side x, that is 4. Enter side y, let's say 5. The hypotenuse is 6.4 and some change. All right, so that's just a simple program that you can make using a function of the math class. So if you would like a copy of this code, I will post this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's a few useful methods of the math class. Oh, and I forgot to tell you guys, like, comment, and subscribe. That is all.